It's a full moon over Ghana. Saturday night in Accra. Full moon over Ghana. Saturday night in Accra. It's a full moon over Ghana. Saturday night in Accra. Full moon over Ghana. Now I would not believe in something. I can't slow down when I get on the vibe. I went to the airport with my passport and my visa, and I got on a ride. A touchdown to Ghana, land in Accra. They say I cry, but when I left the plane, so do I say, my dad say, I'm finally here, and my name's Jose. I feel the love, and I can't complain. You familiar with the Zach Cry game? In the studio with my man Go Sticky, Zach and Biggie with really pop champagne. Charlie, don't you know the women in GH, they put on a show. Got more digits from African shorties and Samsung for selling in tiptoe. Get up in the morning, ride the tro-tro to the sound of the beat they call the afro. The high life, the hip life, Asamo Al-Qaeda, Azanto. So let's go, cuz a full moon over Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra. A full moon over Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra. A full moon over Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra. A full moon over Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra.
I want to ta-ra-ra. I want to turn around and go. Show me how to go, oh my. No body slow. Show me how to go, oh my. No dumb flow. Oh yeah, get in the groove. Get in, yeah, get in the groove. Oh yeah, nah, get in the groove. Now make you start up on the truth. Nah, cause it's on the show.
Watch out for the best. Islam Moore's back home.
Yeah.
I'm in Ghana right now with Muhammad.
That's it.
And I'll tell you the truth, it reminds me of Alu Bayera and Khalif, like 100%. As you can see, those from anywhere in the Caribbean, you'll see this is exactly like home, the same thing, same vibes, same love, same people. So this is the beginning of my trip, this is the first day, just good to be back in 30 plus degree weather. I've been missing it, missing the sun, you know, staying here for a week, seeing what information we can get. Muhammad and I had a great conversation last night about everything from history to politics, to religion, and I'll share that with y'all in the video, but it's just beautiful out here. Say peace to the people, Muhammad.
Hi, this is Moe from Ghana. I'm saying hi to Jamaica, Germany, and Trinidad and Tobago.
All right, Moors, we're at Accra Mall, as you can see. This is crazy, man. Once again, in the car with Muhammad and my brother from another mother, godbrother, cousin, you name it, Jose. He's here in Ghana. Here I came to visit him. Also known as Manchild MC, Sam Glass. You know, say hi to the people, yo.
What's up?
So yeah, we're here at the mall. We're gonna go check it out. Peace.
No language is spoken there. No language is even managed there.
Not only Zongos, it's spoken everywhere.
Oh,
it's spoken everywhere. You go to Ghana, Kasuma is spoken there. You go to East Legon, it's spoken there. Everywhere. How they spoken. It's not like that.
Peace, love, and light, Moors. So we just came back from a mosque and we did Salat. And while I was washing my hands and my feet before I went into the mosque, I was speaking to a guy and he was telling me how recognized the fez, and he was telling me how in olden times they used to wear it. He gave gave me the name of it, but I can't remember the name, obviously, because it's a different language. But I'm here in the car with Muhammad, and he's gonna give a brief story of what it means here in Ghana, or in certain, in different regions has different names, but there's a general meaning to it. So, yeah.
This is Muhammad. Hi, this is Muhammad from Ghana, and I'm here to give you a brief history about the heart, we call it in Ghana. And this heart, it has names based on regions. The name varies based on regional distance. In Accra here, it is called different, which I don't know. In my hometown, we call it Bajie. Bajie, that's B-A-A-G-I-E. Bajie, that's how it is called in my hometown. But the whole country, throughout the entire Ghana, that kind of Bajie, referring to the heart, I mean, it is a kind of heart that is that comes along with a kind of prestige. And if you are wearing it in Ghana, across the nation of Ghana, if you wear this thing, especially with the black this thing behind, we have some without a black rope under. I'm referring to this one with a rope behind. If you wear that one, you are highly recognized, and you are, even in your movement, people will recognize you by giving you salam, like taking you to be a special person, not an ordinary person. The moment you wear this, they feel you are a knowledgeable person, you are a highly respected person, you are somebody in society. It doesn't take a normal person to wear this. So there's a kind of, it comes with a kind of prestige to it. That's the short thing I have to say about this. And it's a very something, it's something that is highly respected in Islam, the culture of Islam, and it is respected in the culture of Ghanaians. I mean the Ghanaian Muslims, and even the non-Muslims, they recognize it as it.
Okay. So, there you have it. I've been walking around with it, this is the second day, and I've been getting recognized. The thing is, I don't know what people are saying, but Muhammad's been telling me, oh, this guy was talking about you because of the fez. He said I was a man of the moment or something like that.
Man of the moment.
Man of the moment. And yeah, just other people were saying stuff. And he's recognizing it because he knows the language.
Yeah. And to add a little bit, because the fez, I mean the hat, it is highly respected to some extent that young folks doesn't wear it. It normally worn by old, especially from 50s onwards. But when they see a young man wearing it, a young man of 40, 43, especially wearing it with t-shirt and this thing, they say, wow, what a combination. Then they say, no, you are the man of the woman. That's more how I listen to that, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so there you have it, Morris. That's why I wear my fez. Well, that's not why I wear my fez all the time, but just, you know, giving respect to my ancient foremothers and forefathers.
Yes, it is.
And also bridging the gap, because obviously here on the motherland, on the continent in Ghana, it's respected as well. So wear your fezes, Moors, wherever you go. And yeah, you'll see what happens. You see the changes happen. A little bit more information. So yeah, like I was saying, the black is the tassel, and the graduation cap.
Yeah.
Then when you graduate from high school or whatever, they took it from this traditional headdress, meaning knowledge. You gain the knowledge, 360 degrees of knowledge. Are you gonna say about your hometown?
Yeah, that could be true, because in my hometown, I can remember when I was growing up. So I was growing up as a young American. That is in the late 70s. In the late 70s to 80s, when we were growing up. If a young boy like my type, or somebody above me or below me wears this, you get caution. People call and caution you.
Caution you?
Yeah. Okay. Why should you wear this? Are you up to wear this? You are not up to the age that you can wear this.
Okay.
All this thing was like, you have to acquire certain status in life before you be able to wear this. That was the recognition and the respect that was given. That kind of hat as I was growing up.
Okay.
So as I was growing up, for a fact, I can never remember as I was growing up seeing a young guy of my type wearing this. Mm. It should be a person when you see, you say, no, this person is supposed to wear this because he's all known.
Mm.
He's highly respected in society, knowledgeable, and it is the kind of thing that is like, if you are highly respected, then you can wear it.
Okay.
Knowledgeable, then you can wear it.
Okay.
Then when you see a young person, like my age, those is wearing this, then that person is somebody else. It's not just an ordinary young boy.
Okay.
It's somebody else.
Okay.
That was how we see it, and that is how the whole Ghana sees it.
Okay.
Yeah. I think that's something small I have to add about.
Okay. That's good to know. That's great to know. A little bit of history there. But in Ghana. As you can see, there's a lot of vendors selling a lot of stuff. God first. I'm telling you, the Christian community here is massive. It's huge. And just on a side note, and TV evangelism is the new drug. If you want to become a millionaire, just become a preacher and you will make money quick, fast, in a hurry. So yeah, Muhammad was telling me about the whole system here with evangelism is growing, and it's just crazy. So yeah, check this out. This is what is going on in Ghana. Heavy. This is what they just really don't know the deal, which is crazy. But then this is all over pretty much the continent. They don't read the Bible, they don't know anything from beginning to end, obviously, and they just believe what the pastor and the kids tell them. So this is heavy. Signs like this are, this is like, I think, the second or third one that I've seen, not on this journey to El Mina, but just in other parts of town. So it's great. It's crazy here, yo. It's really, really crazy.
Township right here.
Mamors, we're inside Castle El Mina. As you can see, I'm gonna be switching to single camera mode because I wanna save on battery. while I film all of this stuff and get as much as information as I can for y'all. Alright, so there's a quick little look. And yeah, I'll be switching to single camera mode. So until then.
In this custom, some of the officers were abusing the women quite sexually. The governor, because it's...
Before the Europeans came, the Africans were also having their own system of slavery. That's a domestic type of slavery. Our community was an indentured slavery, like a free man.
Back from Elmina Castle. It's really interesting. Good experience, and it was cool too because met up with Muslim brother Edi, and we were just talking about a whole bunch of stuff, and even he was saying that the information at the Elmina Castle, what they give out and stuff, he was saying it's incorrect. When I was telling him about how they mentioned there that it took 6 weeks from Ghana to get to the New World by ship in the 1600s. Even he was saying that's not true, it's 3 months. So, but yeah, man, we had a good talk, good build, cool brother. It's a great time. So we're heading back to Accra right now. And yeah, man, just loving this trip, man.
The hustle and bustle of the market. It seems like a market strip. Selling a whole bunch of great food and stuff. Ghana is really sweet. More so just a little commentary about this image. This is Kosa Kantaka. And he is a Ghanaian that's just a brilliant mind. He builds everything. He builds trucks, his own trucks, his own everything. Pretty much he's a one-man Daewoo or a one-man Hyundai or, you know. And the Ghanaians don't support him, so he'll put out cars and nobody's buying them. And, you know, they just don't support his own. So it's really interesting how you have somebody who can make this country self-sufficient by knowing all the engineering stuff to do, to build machines. Like, he built refrigerators, stoves, once again, cars, trucks, air conditions, what else?
TVs,
you name it, any type of electronics, probably even phones too, any type of electronics he can do. He can be like a one-man Sony, like I said, a one-man Samsung,
jacuzzis,
you name it, and none of the locals support him. I think he has his own money.
He has a medicine that he can feed into this thing to more than 1,000.
To what?
A medicine.
He has a medicine to do?
He will give it to
an
animal
that
can lay eggs more than 1,000.
Okay, so he has medicine, as Muhammad was saying. They can give to an animal to lay thousands of eggs. He's just a brilliant mind.
At the same time.
Huh?
Hatch them at the same time.
And hatch them the same time. So he just has a lot of stuff and nobody supports him. But he had his own money. He grew up rich, right?
Yeah, radio stations, consoles, spinners, he funded it all.
What else?
Radio stations.
Radio station. Oh!
Yeah. Radio stations.
Okay, he does it all and he grew up with money and just nobody supports him. So now, can you imagine if the Ghanaians supported him, they wouldn't need any type of imports, and they'd be probably one of, if not the richest countries in Africa with the gold and the silver, and then this guy doing stuff. So, you know, this is something to think about, Morris. It's crazy. And it's a shame.
Really shame.
It's a real shame. Yeah. Anything you want to say?
It's really shame.
Yeah.
It's a shame.
Yeah.
We the Ghanaians, we don't support our own.
Yeah.
it's a shame. I want to support it. I don't. I wish to support him. I'm not the vision. The government should have supported him.
Yeah.
The people in Boston have supported him.
Yeah.
All they did support him. They don't award him contracts. They don't give anything. Imagine with all this knowledge, the government still have to go to China and buy cars from there.
Yeah.
They don't have to go to China, buy chairs. They don't have to go to China, buy trucks. They don't have to go to China, buy a whole lot of things.
Yeah.
While he's here.
Yeah.
If all this is awarded to him.
Have it, short little brief story. Do your research on him. See the star there up there with the Africa on top of the star. Star. Love, truth, peace, freedom,
and love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice.
And he called himself the African star. You know, he supposedly bleaches his skin and he straightens his hair, so some people have a problem with that. But regardless, man, you have somebody this brilliant in your country and you're not supporting him to make you this country more self-sufficient. So with that, I say peace, love, and light in Islam, Moors, and we'll, you know, update y'all again soon.
No,
I didn't.
Sorry.
That's alright. Alright, Moors, that was just a little accident there, but yeah, so here is the poster that you need to see. Let's see if I can get this. Yeah, it's coming up. And it's a UNICEF poster. So see that? Imagine Ghana where no child has to grow up poor. Now the thing about this is that, as I was explaining before about Katanka, that's building all these things, that could build all this stuff and make Ghana extremely independent, and nobody's supporting him. But then they be talking about UNICEF helping out and all this stuff when they can help themselves out. I'm telling you, man, when I see this, it's a shame. In my opinion, this is a total shame, man, because Ghana has the opportunity to be fully independent, and then there's, you know, your little crest, and it says freedom and justice. Five-pointed star, and that's the two last principles in our Moorish movement: love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. So look at that. Freedom and justice, but then they don't want to support their own. So just a little commentary. All right, peace, love, and light. Peace, love, Islam. Hear that, Moors? Mohammed said, peace, love, and light, Moors. Peace, love, and Islam, Moors. That's what he said. Islam, Moors, we're here at the W.E.B. Du Bois Memorial Center. This is the house that he lived in, correct?
Yeah.
This on the camera right now is the house that he lived in. We're about to go inside and check it out. As you can see, the sign
this
and...
Way he was buried.
Hmm?
This where he buried.
And this is where he's mausoleum. Buried. Yeah. It's the mausoleum where he's buried. As you can see in the background, I'm going to zoom it for you. See that? Let's see if you get that. A sign in the background that says W.E.B. Du Bois Memorial Center. See it in the back there. It's a little bit blurry because it's bright outside today. But yeah, we're here and we're gonna check it out. That's his house. So, see y'all inside. Little sign on the side of the house.
So, where are you?
you can't video yet.
Oh, okay. Morris, that was it. I did the tour. Unfortunately, we were not allowed to film on the inside, but I took a whole bunch of pictures. I think what was really interesting is the Africana encyclopedias that W.E. Du Bois was editing, and that one of the projects telling the history of Africa. I'm definitely going to research that. I think we should all research that and see if we can get that. What? That's the beautiful Ghanaian woman that was giving me the tour as she walks away. Yeah. So just letting you know, I think it's one thing that we should research, because there might be some pertinent information on Moorish culture in there, which I'm pretty sure there is. And I've heard that you can get it, you can view it online, those encyclopedias, and you can order it from Amazon. So it's one thing to check out. I have a picture of it. I think I got a picture of it. I hope I got a picture of it. And I'll probably just pop it up in this video that I'm filming right now. So yeah, man, this is the compound. As y'all see, Boys Museum. And it's beautiful, man. It's beautiful. Here's a little bust, I think. I'm gonna walk here and take a picture of this bust. But I think what was interesting about, you know, this man is, he was working, traveling around the world and working on correcting, you know, situation in Northwest Amexum with regards to quote unquote racism and stuff like that. So anyways, y'all know this already. But yeah, so that's it. Signing off. Till next video, Moors. Love y'all. Peace, love, and light, and Islam. Love and light, Moors. once again, we're out on the road. I'm gonna see my cousin, and this is my final evening, I should say, in Ghana. I still got tomorrow all day, and then my flight is tomorrow night. And yeah, we're on our way to see my cousin because he leaves tomorrow morning, going back to the US. Yesterday, we went to the W.E.B. Du Bois Center, and there's something that happened to us after we went there. We went to a restaurant. What was the name? The 22? What was something 22?
Something restaurant. Something.
Yeah, something 22, yeah. Restaurant 22, something, yeah. Like that. I can't remember the name. But as I walked in and I went to the back, the waiter, and this is what Mohammed was telling me, the waiter said, "Welcome, Your Highness."
Yeah,
tell the story, tell.
Yeah, we just went into the restaurant and one of the attendants just see and spoke in our own language, that is Ghana, and he said, "Welcome, Your Highness." And I replied to him that he doesn't understand what you are saying. He was laughing with me, and I just explained it back to Mr. Chanel.
Okay. Yeah, so the fez and the tassel. Yeah, like I was saying before, it's another level out here when you wear it, the tassel. People who recognize it give a lot of respect. So that's something that happened to me yesterday. It was very interesting when Mohammed explained it to me. So, as you can see, you know how they drive in the Caribbean too. So, you know, this is nothing new for you guys. So yeah, just another story to the multitudes of other stories that happen. And so yeah, tomorrow during the day, hopefully, it's been raining the last 3 days, wanted to go to the beach, and when it rains, it's not a good idea here to go to the beach because the water gets really, really dangerous and aggressive. So last 3 days we wanted to go, we didn't go. Hopefully tomorrow will be sunny. Based on the way the sky is looking, I think from the camera on my phone, sky looks kind of cloudy, but it looks like it might clear up tomorrow. So hopefully I could get, you know, I could get me sea bats. I want the sea bat, the salt water and the sun, right? So hopefully I get me sea bat tomorrow, and yeah, it'll be all good. So that's a little brief story. Till next time, I'll be filming a little bit more tomorrow depending on what we do. But yeah, till next time, love y'all, stay strong. Peace, love and light is wars and Islam. Peace, love and light, Moors. This is my last evening in beautiful Ghana. On my way to the airport now with Mohammed.
Hi.
Frideos. Ajwa. And Rasul. Yeah, so
we are giving him a family escort. A family escort to the airport. Saying goodbye, peace and love.
Yeah, great, great time. Definitely, definitely coming back. For sure. Yeah, man, just reminds me of, like I keep saying, Al-Bayer and Khalib and Jamaica and all over. So, Sheldon McKenzie L signing out. Peace, love, and light, and Islam, Moors. Islam, Moors, I think Rasul has something to say. Talk to him, Rasul. Talk to them. Tell them what's up.
Young Moor.
Tell him what's up, Rasul. Rasul! You let them know who's in charge.
I tell you.
A full moon of a Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra. A full moon of a Ghana, a Saturday night in Accra.